Tonight, a story of survival, surviving the loss of seven children.
The children were killed in a house fire 1 year ago today. News 8's Matt Barcaro visited the Klaus family in Perry County to find out what got them through the year.
Nothing about the past year has been easy for the Klaus family. The highs were not nearly as high, the lows a little lower than usual. But through it all, there have been two constants, family and the farm.
Some ways it went really fast, and other ways it went really slow. But on a farm, it's always busy, so that always helps preoccupy your mind, I guess.
The Klaus's dairy farm near Loysville has grown in the last year. There are more cows than ever, and calves set to join the herd. But as smooth as the farm is running, and as normal as their lives look, that's just not the case.
Almost seems like yesterday. I can still see, you know, come up over the hill here and see the house on fire.
1 year ago, the Klaus's farmhouse caught fire and they could do nothing but watch it. Ted was out hauling milk at a nearby farm that night. Janelle was working in the barn. Their eight children were just settling in to sleep, and only one made it out.
It still gives butterflies in the stomach. Yeah, it still makes me sort of sick.
The image of the burning house and the feeling of helplessness have not faded one bit.
Of that part of the night, it sure isn't nice. It's something you can always live with as long as you have your memory.
Janelle tries not to remember the days after the fire. The cold and rainy days, she says, matched her mood. Or the day of the funeral when they buried seven small white caskets.
And even now, it sometimes still kind of shocks me. And I think, are my children really all gone except two? And it hits you, you know, certain times. And
it's hard to believe it happened, but I guess it was all according to the plan. You know, I guess it's the way the good Lord wanted it, so that's the way it will be.
The same week the farmhouse burned, neighbors tore it down. They wanted to erase the physical reminder of those seven losses. They built a new home for the Klauses across the road. In the last year, Leah, the only survivor of the fire, turned 4 years old. Also turning four, the number of Klaus family members. Janelle gave birth to Gabriel in June.
He's always happy and greets you with a smile, and you know, it makes your day better when you see him.
But the family still feels incomplete.
People that don't know you, like in the store and stuff, they say, oh, that's so cute, you have a boy and a girl, and it's just kind of like, no, it's really not, because it should have been about, you know, eight girls and two boys, but of course they don't know, so. But it's always there, it'll never be the same.
Grass has grown where the farmhouse once stood, but it's a scar that will not heal. Because when the Klauses look out the upstairs window in their new house, they still see the children's bedroom facing them.
It's kind of haunting, actually. So I don't do that too much.
Ted and Janelle think about the children they lost every day. Some days it's just one. Some days it's all seven of them. The memories of the children are always with the Klauses, and sometimes it's beyond their control.
I do have dreams of the children, just dreams of stuff happening in life that would have happened if they were here. And then you wake up and reality hits again.
Focusing on reality is painful, but it has gotten them through the year. Ted parked his milk truck the night he drove back to see the burning house. He has not run a route since, spending all his time now at the farm, where he's closer to home.
I guess it's like everything else, we have to keep going ahead. You can't live in the past. Don't forget the past, but you can't live in it, because you can't change the past.
As for the future, a quiet house may get a little less quiet. Janelle is expecting again. The newest Klaus is due in June, and she will enter a house with a reaffirmed sense of family.
You never know how long you're going to have with a loved one, and you better make the best of it, because there's no promise that tomorrow they're going to be there to hug and kiss and love on. So that's probably one of the greatest lessons I've learned.
And that's a realization that has made healing from an agonizingly difficult year at all bearable. There still is heart in heartbreak, and they cherish it.
Ted and Janelle wanted to thank everyone who helped them throughout the year, especially the days and the weeks after the fire. So many people gave money and clothes and well wishes. Janelle told me that they received thousands of cards and letters. The mailman would come to them every day with a box of things. Some stuff even came as far away as Hawaii and Australia. And the Klauses, they held on to everything they received. Mm-hmm. They hope one day they can go back and look at them. But they still do get some letters, especially on the children's birthdays, just as a well wish.
It is so unspeakably sad, and they are doing so remarkably well.
They are. There definitely is pain there, but for the first time speaking publicly, you know, you can tell. It's always with them.
Well, certainly a lot of people hold them up in prayer.
Absolutely.
All right.